In this video, I'll be going deep into the Microsoft Education Solutions Guide. This is a prescriptive set of guidelines that's designed specifically for education customers and organizations, and it's like a step-by-step blueprint for deploying Microsoft services in an EDU environment. And it's really focused on IT administrators and education professionals or partners, and it has best practices, step-by-step deployment guidance for K-12 schools, districts, higher ed institutions, tenant configurations, all of our different SKUs, security, and a whole lot more. Now to get started, what you're seeing here is the landing page for the Education Solutions Guide, aka ESG. And the link is on the screen. It's also in the description, really easy to get to. And you can see the three stages here, the online libraries, Copilot and AI, and change management. And the little way that we refer to things, baseline is the A1 license features and functionality, standard is A3, and then advanced is A5. And also we're gonna scroll down, you're gonna see the different phases here. You can see the illustrations and icons, A1, A3, and A5. And then the other important part is the different sections. So we've got tenant setup, identity, applications, security compliance, and then devices. And as we walk through this, you're gonna see these icons and the way that that is structured. And the way to think about it is you move from the baseline and then into standard A3 if you're doing that. And then the advanced folks who are using A5, we cover things again at the end, identity, applications, and security. And there's a bunch of links and documentation and resources down at the bottom. So let's start out at baseline. And I'm gonna expand this and I'm gonna go into baseline overview. And again, that is the equivalent of A1. Hey, you're just getting started. So there's a bunch of great documentation on everything from tenant setup, and I'm not going to go through each of these, but just to give an example, you click here in step one, it tells you exactly how to create your tenant, how to configure your tenant, how to add domain. So that's really just step one. I'm brand new to this. And there's a whole bunch of steps here. There's also core parts of identity and how to configure Microsoft Entra. Again, I won't go through all these, but a lot of very specific and detailed steps of getting yourself configured with Entra ID. Then you move on to applications, and in A1, there's a core set of applications available, Exchange, Teams for Education, OneDrive and SharePoint, a set of security tools, and then basic device management. And then down here, you can see all the different apps that you're licensed for. And there's a ton of stuff, everything from classroom tools like OneNote Class Notebook, learning tools, Reading Coach, learning accelerators, Stream, Forms, Lists, but then things like e-discovery and auditing, email, calendar, and scheduling, and all the things that come with A1. And again, I'm not gonna go through each of these, but a lot of folks have said, gosh, what comes with A1 versus A3 or A5? And this has all the details. And again, those are the products and features that I was just talking about and showing. Right here, A1 product and features, there are tons and tons of links and information and explanations on each of these. Links to Microsoft Learns courses. So if you're like, hey, what's the OneNote Class Notebook? If you click this, you can go directly into the articles and content all about these different products and features. That covers A1. That's the baseline. Now let's say, you know what? I'm using A3 in my organization. We call that standard. And here's the standard overview. So it assumes everything in A1 plus the additional capabilities that you get with A3. And you can see these same icon types of breakdowns, setup, identity, applications you get. So you get more things. You get webinars, SharePoint Plan 2, you get more Exchange storage, Viva Insights, Viva Learning, and other things that you get. Some of the big updates in this standard, aka A3, you get more advanced security and threat protection and e-discovery and auditing and deeper endpoint analytics, things like that. So you can explore all the new capabilities that you get when you have this standard or A3. Again, I won't go through all this, but you get a sense of what types of things you get in addition to A1. And then the final one is advanced, and this is A5, and a lot of customers have A5. If I go here, it shows now you get Entra Plan 2. You get Entra ID protection, more governance. You get more Power BI and analytics. Again, Power BI Pro, more advanced Teams features. So you can go through all of the extra capabilities that you get with advanced or A5. And again, for products and features, you can drill in deep and see all the different things that you get when you have A5. Finally, we've got add-ons. So things like Copilot might be an add-on if you had advanced Copilot Premium. You have Power Apps, SharePoint and Storage, other add-ons that we have, compliance add-ons. You can explore those. And then devices is the final one. So how do you manage devices? Maybe you have Windows 11 Pro for education. Maybe you're using Azure Virtual Desktop. If you're upgrading from Windows 10 to Windows 11, lots of great information here as well. Now wrapping up, we will soon have a link to submit requests. If you're a partner and you want assistance for any feature or product and you need more help, you will be able to submit tickets to this Microsoft Education Solution Guide if you want updates or fixes. Now to wrap up, whether you're just starting your digital journey with A1 licenses or you're expanding capabilities to A3 or maximizing investments with A5, the Microsoft ESG provides a great prescriptive set of expertise that you need for every step. So get started, aka.ms/ESG. That link is on the screen. It's also in the description, and you can get all the comprehensive documentation and step-by-step tutorials that you need.